Adding greenery to the image is tricky, as this is what can make or break your image. Not only do you need high-quality models, but also you have to recreate plant scenario as close to reality as possible. By the end of this video, you'll learn how to approach forest scenes to make them look realistic. I will be using one of the scenes from our RVs Artist interior and exterior visualizations training. If you want to check it out, I put the link in the corner and in the description below. First things first. If any plants play a key role in your scene, you should always make sure you position them before setting up the camera. Otherwise, it may drastically change the way you perceive the space and how these 3D objects affect the composition. Talking about composition, we can approach forest visualization like this as a landscape shot, meaning that we can, or even should, add at least two of these elements, foreground, middle ground, and background. This will help us achieve more three-dimensional images and a sense of depth in the visualization. The most powerful results we'll achieve when using all of them, like in this case. So we have a foreground mainly with low plants, trunks, and grass, then the middle ground with the cabin, and at the end, we have a background with the fog, which also helps in conveying depth in the image. Another essential part of getting realistic results is understanding the forest structure, so that each forest is more or less similar in terms of that. We have the emergent layer with the tall trees, then we have a canopy layer, which is the thickest one of all, and it refers to the highest branches and leaves of the trees, which serve as a roof over other plants and the forest floor. We have also the understory layer, consisting of immature and small trees, and the forest floor, which is the very low part. So in this case, we started by adding some trees to create a canopy layer. I wanted some leafy trees, so I think this type will be perfect. It's a tree from Glow Plants, I put the link in the description below the video. Another important thing to keep in mind is making sure that your plant will vary. Use scale and rotation tools to differentiate them from each other. Also, try to create a layering effect, meaning cover some parts of the building to make it look more natural, not perfectly arranged. I want to keep the view visible from the cabin, so I won't add any more trees on the line from the camera to lake. Keeping the forest structure in mind, let's work on the understory layer. As we have a mixed forest in this case, I choose a small coniferous tree. By the way, using tags for this is a great option. Also, I think it may be useful to use tags related to the geographical occurrence of the plant. For example, Europe, North America, Australia, and so on. We can make it even more specific if it's important for the projects we do. It will be very helpful if we work on international projects. As I have only one tree in this file, I'll merge it as a proxy straight away. It's very important in scenes like this, if you want to avoid having trouble with a laggy viewport or software crashes. I won't put a lot of trees as they won't be visible anyway, so there is no reason for that. A few of them in the front are good enough. But I encourage you to test various scenarios for learning purposes, so you have a good understanding of what works and what it doesn't. We have the base done. Now we can work on the details. Forest floor layer. This time, I use a filtering option with the end operator. To make searching faster, I search only for tagged assets. Forest is not just about the beautifully growing trees, but also the dry or decaying plants, rocks, stones, grasses, and so on. I definitely add some trunks to make forest look more convincing. I would like to have a longer trunk laying on the ground. I choose one more to add some variety. It's worth spending some time on this as it's a foreground, so it not only has to fit the composition, but also look good and natural. We can preview the textures to see if it's good for the foreground, and also we can check here if the textures are linked. We can add the rocks first. Keep in mind composition. Make sure the rocks don't attract too much attention. Besides, I also add some stumps. The idea is to make it as natural as we can, so remember to clutter some objects together and leave others alone. Make sure the trunks are not positioned in the same direction or at the same distance from one another. These details are what makes a difference, what makes the forest look natural. So definitely spend time on this part. By the way, the plugin I'm using today is Connector by Design Connected, and it's free for individual users. For example, in the latest version, they added a hybrid DAM option that lets you upload the entire library in a cloud storage of your choice. I'm 100% for organization library regularly, but life is life and I know how it often looks in practice. This is why I think the rating is a great idea. Different people from the team can judge the assets, so not only you can know which ones are better to use in the projects, but also which ones are ready to be out of the library. To make sure that our composition is well-balanced and interesting, I use the framing effect. It will help to focus attention on the cabin and its view. Plus, I use the leafy tree in the front to make sure the image is nicely cropped and balanced. It will actually look more like a shrub here, and that's fine. At the end, we can add ferns and grasses to finish the planting topic. I use chaos scatter for that. At the end, we can add ferns and grasses to finish the planting topic. We have to adjust the numbers of objects so it looks natural. Adding the spline for excluding the area is a great way if you, for example, want to create a path, but also in situations like those when we want to create an impression of diversity. Additionally, we can add the grass as a base for everything. We can reduce the size to keep it small. Keeping all of these steps in mind is crucial if you want to make sure you get close to reality results. Having photo references is always a good idea too. If you want to learn the whole process of creating this forest visualization and three other exterior scenarios, join our Arc Wizardy's Advanced Exterior Visualization Training. You can also watch other videos on similar topics here on YouTube. Bye!